Welcome, students, to the geography of class 8. I will tell you a short story of Mamba and Peter. In a small village in Tanzania, in the continent of Africa, Mamba is a little girl who gets up very early in the morning to fetch water. She has to walk a long way and returns after a few hours. She then helps her mother in the house and joins her brothers in taking care of their goats. All her family owns is a piece of rocky land around their small hut. Mamba's father can barely grow some maize and beans on it after toiling very hard. It is not enough to feed the family for the whole year. On the other side, Peter is a little boy who lives in the heart of the sheep-rearing region in New Zealand, where his family runs a wool processing factory. Every day when he returns from school, Peter watches his uncle taking care of their sheep. Their sheep yard is situated on a wide grassy plain with hills in the far distance. It is managed in a scientific way using the latest technology. Peter's family also grows vegetables through organic farming. Both Mamba and Peter stay in two different parts of the world and lead very different lives. This difference is because of the differences in the quality of land, soil, water, natural vegetation, animals, and the usage of technology. The availability of such resources is the main reason places differ from each other. Therefore, students, we shall begin with the second chapter, Land, Soil, Water, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife Resources. In this video, we shall only learn about land, the land use and land conservation. Land is among the most important natural resources. It covers only about 30% of the total area of the Earth's surface, and all parts of this small percentage are not habitable. The uneven distribution of population in different parts of the world is mainly due to varied characteristics of land and climate. The rugged topography, steep slopes of the mountains, low-lying areas susceptible to waterlogging, desert areas, thick forested areas are normally sparsely populated or uninhabited. Plains and river valleys offer suitable land for agriculture. Therefore, these are the densely populated areas of the world. Now we shall look at the land use. Land is used for different purposes such as agriculture, forestry, mining, building houses, roads, and setting up of industries. This is commonly termed as land use. Now can you recall the different ways in which Mamba's and Peter's family use their land? The use of land is determined by the physical and the human factors. The physical factors such as topography, soil, climate, minerals, and availability of water. On the other hand, the human factors include population and technology, which are the important determinants of land use pattern. Land can also be divided on the basis of private land and community land. Private land is owned by individuals, whereas community land is owned by the community for common uses like collection of fodder, fruits, nuts or medicinal herbs. These community lands are also called common property resources. People and their demands are ever growing, but the availability of land is limited. The quality of land also differs from place to place. People started encroaching the common lands to build up commercial areas, housing complexes in the urban areas, and to expand the agricultural land in the rural areas. Today, the vast changes in the land use pattern also reflect the cultural changes in our society. Land degradation, landslides, soil erosion, desertification are the major threats to the environment because of the expansion of agriculture and constructional activities. Now let us learn the conservation of land resource. The growing population and their ever-growing demands has led to a large-scale destruction of forest cover and arable land and has created a fear of losing this natural resource. Therefore, the present rate of degradation of land resources must be checked. A few methods of conservation of land could be afforestation, land reclamation, regulated use of chemical, pesticide and fertilizers, and to keep a check on overgrazing. These common methods could be used to conserve land. So students, today we have learned about land as an important natural resource. We have learned also about the land use, in which we have learned the two important determinants of land use pattern. We have classified land on the basis of private and community owned. We know what are the causes of land degradation, and we put light on the conservation of land resources. With this, we come to an end of this subtopic. In the next video, we shall begin with the subtopic soil. Thank you.